Instead of reporting the width in the number of physical hardware pixels, the browser reports the width in the number of DIPs, or device-independent pixels. As its name implies, a device-independent pixel is a unit of measurement that actually relates pixels to a real distance. The idea being that a device-independent pixel will take up the same amount of space on a display regardless of the pixel density of the display.
So if there are twice as many hardware pixels across as there are pixels reported by the browser, the Chromebook pixel must have a device pixel ratio of 2?
Right. The browser has a viewport width of 1280 dips. The 1280 dips get scaled up to 2560 hardware pixels when the page is rendered on the display.
Back to my unoptimized website. What's the browser doing when the viewport isn't set?
Unless you tell the browser that your site was designed to work on a small screen, it assumes that they weren't and renders the page as if it were on a screen that were 980 dips wide. Now, imagine that content being scaled to fit on a phone that's only 360 dips wide. It gets scaled to less than half. Yuck. It then tries to make the content look better by doing something called font boosting. The browser tries to pick the primary content on the page and scale it up.
Oh, wait a second. So now the browser is actually trying to guess at what content is important? This sounds like a problem.
Yep, that means that some fonts are large and easy to read, while others remain small and are really hard to read. Users will have to spend a lot of time pinching to zoom in order to see and interact with the content.
That is not ideal.
Nope.